Hey, good afternoon, Manchester, New Hampshire, and all the surrounding area. We are here now with Adventurecam. Okay, well, Adventurecam, you know, close.
You know, what's in that water?
Yeah, well, I'll never tell. But they're here. They have been on. This is your third time.
Yes, right? It is.
Third time, and they are growing more and more notoriety. I think I'm getting a little jealous. They get more notoriety than my beautiful body. Yeah,
no, that's impossible.
But you know how it is. And we are here with Candyman, Jerry Seaver, and Rich. I think I gotta try to pronounce your last name.
Damboise.
That's
so swearing at some boys.
There you go. And they just come back from doing a haunted house, right?
Correct.
A couple of them, actually.
Good. So you're really making progress.
Yeah, we're learning a lot about the paranormal. And
but you don't do just paranormal. Do you do just paranormal, or you do other as well?
Well, right now it seems like that's what we keep getting pulled into. You know, we get calls, and we're doing some places that are very famous haunted houses.
And it
really is great to cut our teeth on where some of the big guys have been and just see what's really out there and learn the reaction between us and spirits.
My question to you, do you ask their permission before you enter? Of the spirits, do you let them know that you're coming in to communicate with them?
Not up until now, I guess.
I'm like, honestly, I always, as you know, I'm not a big advocate of it to begin with, you know.
Right.
But I would honestly ask you to ask their permission if you may communicate with them, because I think that's important. Because if you go in your call, it's like you going in to a house and with a bunch of people there, or like what I do at a second convention or whatever. I always feel it's important that you ask their permission. And I am willing to bet that you will get a lot of better responses from them.
Okay, the next one we will.
Yeah, we will.
We introduced ourselves, though. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's true, but let them know.
No, that's a good thing, because a lot of people don't. A lot of people go in and say, no, I know you're Bob Smith is here, and you know they don't want you here to leave. You know, no, you're just causing trouble when you do that.
You're telling you're there to help them and not hurt them. Always make sure you always go in there with a real positive but gentle attitude.
And that is one thing we do go in with, and we actually talk about it on that on the episode with the Houghton Mansion, on the ride down, that, you know, this is a real positive family. It was a great family that was very close, and unfortunately some tragic things happened with that family.
There's a lot of suicide in that last house that you went to, wasn't there?
There was one in the Houghton Mansion that we know of that we actually connected with.
Five suicides in there.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Wow.
The one that was a leader, that one that you talked to, was the one that welcomed you with great respect, because you're respecting them. Okay.
John Witters is one of them.
John Witters, yeah.
I'm sorry?
John Witters, he was one.
Yeah. See, when you respect, they're going to respect you. I've seen so many of them that, wow, this is over here. Or that's over here. But you don't hear the respect. You hear the matter of fact type way of doing it. People can, you know, people, if you disagree with me, feel free to call me and tell me, you know.
Yeah.
That's what I'm here for, right? You know, but I think, don't you agree, you have to respect the spirits.
You should be respectful. The one thing, though, when you go in and so you go to the Houghton Mansion, you're told that it's haunted, so you go in and you're respectful and you address the ghost. And people who don't believe in that will say, well, you know, they're just making it up because they're just, you know. No, you whether they're there or not, you're going in and you're being respectful. That's
right.
Just common courtesy, the way to do it.
Right.
You know, it's not like you're, you know, if you're going into a place you don't know is haunted, you're still going to go in with that same courtesy just in case.
Yeah,
you never know.
Yeah.
Right?
You have two spirits in your house that are laughing at what you're doing, by the way.
In my house?
Yeah. They think it's funny.
Oh, my.
Maybe today
I would probably encourage you to track them in your own house before you start tracking other people.
Really? Wow.
There's a young man and an older man, the father and son. Then they're watching and they're really laughing at you. Okay, when you know that you've done something and it isn't, and you, like, we'll say that you put something over here, okay, and you know damn well, I can say that, right?
I already did.
Over here.
That's okay.
And you know you put it over here.
I thought it was my memory going.
No,
that happens to me all the time.
They're messing with you.
Yeah, or if you might, or like with you, Jerry, I know I shut that punch light off, okay? And you'll see it back on.
Right.
Do your own experiment out of your own house before you experiment with others. Like, wow. This is what my spirit is telling your spirits. Does that make sense to you at all?
Yes, it does. It does.
And when you go on, and you got to do that elderly motorcycle run. I shouldn't use the word elderly, but you know, well, you and I are elderly. Let's be honest. So,
yeah.
You know, but you got to do that one more time.
My wife keeps saying no, but I love the idea.
You have.
I'm missing
it
so much.
And the reason why, and the reason why is that will bring closure to you.
Really?
I had my last run, and I did really well. I could see you winning in the second or third place, which is okay. But you have to do that for you. And honestly, you're going to open up your wrestling camp that you want to open up.
I haven't thought of it. I did years ago, but there was a lot of cash involved.
When the time is right.
Right now, I'm focusing on this. This is very important.
But I'm just telling
you,
okay? When the time is right, because you two are going to have different adventures. Okay? First of all, you're a glory seeker. You're like I am. We're glory seekers. We love the spotlight.
I love it more than you can imagine.
You know what I'm saying? Like my son loves it. You know, once you're in the spotlight, and you're really learning how to like the spotlight, too. Because once you're in the spotlight, you know, it's hard to get away. That's like I love what I do.
Yeah.
You know, in the spotlight. This area, it's for my own ego, you know. And then I have a great, and you're in the spotlight, right? We both enjoy it, right?
Okay.
Yeah, see, we got
right there.
But it's fun, you know, as long as you don't abuse it and become obnoxious with it.
Especially when you're in front of thousands of people, it's even better.
I've not got that lucky yet. Well, if it's meant to be, it will. But I definitely will tell you, and I really believe this, Jerry, you are going to be running a camp to teach people, especially the less fortunate people, because you're not going to be in it for them. You're still going to be doing what you're doing, but it's going to be something that you're going to be helping you and Sailor, what's his name, Thomas there?
Popeye?
What's his name, the big seal, that big Afro-American guy, the big black guy. We used to...
In wrestling?
Yeah. Sailor Scott, what's his name?
Sailor Thomas?
Yeah.
Sailor Thomas?
Yeah.
Who is he?
He's in WWE. Where you been?
You got a different name. But, excuse me? I know a lot in the 60s.
The one thing I got to say, I love the way there's finally some action going on with WWE. We know it's not real, obviously.
Yeah.
But
it's
you
all
know
show.
What? It's entertainment.
Well, that's what makes you drawn to the TV, because there's excitement going on.
It's a man's entertainment.
With the father and son goes at it, and the daughter, then the father says, get out of here. And people are like, wow, this really happening? Come on, seriously?
Yeah. And that's like, I remember when they did it with Linda, how they had her in the wheelchair and all that.
They pile-drived her.
You know. And this is all, but you know what? I've been watching since I was 10 years old. Of course, I'm only 34.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
33, you said. I thought.
Well, 30. I'm going to be 32.
Yes. Okay.
He goes backwards.
Yeah. Well, you do the same, right?
Of course.
If people would, if you realize, in our hearts, we're only that age, you know. Age is only a number. You could be, we had a lady calling, I'm 55 or 59.
Yeah, he told her she needed to go dancing. She said, I can't, I'm way too old. And he said, well, how old are you? She said, 56. And we went, what?
Why do people, I don't understand people.
To be 56 again, huh? Yeah.
55, 50, I'm old. You know, if you feel old, if you say you're old, you're going to be old, you're going to be
absolutely
young.
Absolutely.
Think young. Be a Toys R Us kid for the rest of your life.
Exactly.
Enjoy
I
life.
I never want to live an old life.
Never.
I don't have time to get old.
No. I could never picture you sitting in a rocking chair. Well, mother, bring the tea over to me with a blanket here, or you know.
I mountain bike with 30-year-olds, to be honest with you. My nephew, you know, he keeps me moving. And that's what I got to do. I mean, my dad was the same way. He's still alive at, you know, almost 90 right now.
Wow.
April, he'll be 90.
He's going to make it to 97.
Yeah. Man,
I mean,
I hope I can last that long.
Huh?
Well, yeah, it just made me think of my grandfather. I think he worked until he was like 96. I mean, you know, part time, 10 hours and stuff, but you know.
See, that's the thing. You have a great relationship with your dad, right?
Yeah.
And I listen to these people and I hear them moaning and groaning about their moms and their dads and all that. I wish I could say I knew what a mom and dad was like, you know?
Yeah.
So, but I don't. But you know what? That's okay. I have a great relationship with my son, and you guys know him, you know?
Oh, sure.
And my granddaughter and stuff. If people would just stop fighting with each other.
Over stupid stuff. Yeah. Usually, yeah. It's almost always stupid stuff.
Yeah. You watch, like, I watch, once in a while, I watch Judge Judy.
Yeah.
Or I watch all these, and I listen to the mother suing the father, you know, everybody's suing everybody. And then come find out in one of those Scrabble papers there, the rag papers there, they're all actors.
Oh.
I'm sure.
I did not know that.
How can anybody go on TV, I don't know who the father of my child is? Come on.
Like Jerry Springer Show.
Yeah.
They called me to go on here one time. It was all planned out. I'm like, I didn't want to do it.
My son was deployed with a girl she was in the military, so she had to stop while she was in the military. But she said she'd been on, like, you know, 4, 5, 6 of those different shows playing different people.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm like, so why do people watch that and buy into it?
It's because it's entertainment.
That's all it is.
It's stupid.
People
want to
see excitement. They don't want to see just look at TV. They want to see people going crazy.
That's like with my show, you know. I honestly say, like, no, folks, they're not actors. These are real. Well, they're actors in a respect that they're on the show, but they're real, true, honest people and hardworking people. Well, I don't know what the heart on your part, Jerry. But, you know.
if you watch it and you think it's real, then they're doing a good job.
That's right.
They're convincing you to make it look real, because that's what they are, actors. Like when I get in the ring, there were so many times that I wasn't hurt, but I played the part. And even the other wrestler was like, "Man, you all right?" I was like, "Yeah, I'm just at work." Yeah. They thought I was serious.
I went to one of these.
You got to know how to do it. Yeah.
I went down to one of these shows they had down here when they actually had a TV show in here, but it was. I don't remember the name of it now. And this guy looked like he was really, literally beating the hell out of this other guy. I mean, literally. And I'm like, oh, my God. You know, I'm really getting into it. So I went over to him and I said, "Are you okay?" He goes, "Yeah, why?" I go, "But he was beating, you know." And he said, "No, I'll see." He took his shirt off. I go, "Oh, my God, that attack." But anyways,
for a different reason.
Yeah, and I'm there. Oh, my God. So that's what I always knew. But back in the 60s, they did a heck of a lot better job of acting this out than they do today.
Yeah, it was more wrestling back then than like today.
My foster mother, I call her my mother, she would sit in the chair back in the days of the 50s and 60s, right? And she'd be pounding on me, "Look what that guy's doing." I literally would have to move into another chair, you know, because that's how real they, and it wasn't all with the butts hanging out and all that.
Well, that's what sells today.
Yeah, especially when the kids in the arenas.
Yeah, I know, but it's unfortunate that
let's be honest, Thickney is a jerk. We all know that. But you know what? He doesn't care. He making his money, and he's
still making more.
And he's making a lot more.
And he doesn't care what anybody thinks.
No.
He's a billionaire. And,
and then some.
Yeah.
I used to like the battle they had between him and Donald Trump.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So what have you got planned after all that battling? What have you got planned for your next adventure?
For the next adventure, I think we're going to, we were going to go to Foothills, but have the other mansion.
Governor's Mansion.
Up in Hampton Falls. Yeah.
What's a Hampton Falls?
It's a Governor's Mansion. It's a haunted house.
With a windmill.
It's just a windmill and the
Governor's house. Where? I mean, where is it?
Hampton Falls, New Hampshire?
Yeah.
Out on the seacoast, like next to Hampton.
You know,
Hampton Beaches.
Yeah, oh yeah.
It's right next to
that. I can tell you a story, but I won't.
It was on Ghost Hunters, and I saw it.
Spirit Hunters.
No, Ghost Hunters is a TV show.
I know, that's a TV show.
But there was on there. That's how I saw it. So I wrote to the guy, and he called me back and wants us to go up there.
And he wants to bring a girl.
Yes, because he said the spirits are attracted to women.
My friend Colleen.
She is. No, she's not going, is she? Would you bring her?
Yeah, she's so tied up right now. It's hard to. Through May.
It's April 30th, this one.
Yeah.
But we get.
You'll find a person you will find the right person. Okay. But you want someone that's not looking for the glory of being there. You want someone that really wants to be there.
Okay? Yes.
And someone that doesn't want your body, But I think that you. You know, I think you are probably going to be one of the most successful, I know that you're going to be one of the most successful travel reality shows going.
Well, that's what we're hoping for.
That's the plan, I guess. Our dream, anyway.
Yeah.
It's going in the right direction. So.
We're
going
to find you someone to. I would love to have you do a show here on this station, to be honest with you. But, you know, when you live here, if you could find it. I don't know why Marcel wouldn't.
Yeah, like I said, I think he's got a lot going on in his life, and
well, he's afraid of the unknown.
Yeah.
Like when I told him about the spirits, and he doesn't want to remove them. He's very happy with the spirits, and they're not bothering him. Right. You know, and he's happy there. They're happy there. And like you said, there was a little consultation there between you and him about you leaving the band. But yeah. I think you had to. It was hard for you to leave.
Yeah.
Because this is what you're doing now. It's tied up a lot, and you're not being fair to the band members by going on and, well, I can't make it here, I can't, so you're really...
It's exactly how I put it with these guys. I don't want to get to that point where I'm always saying, geez, I can't make it, and, you know, disappoint them and have them trying to find another guy, and it's not right, and I know where I'm going with the band.
Yeah,
I had my shot back in the 90s. And
my son did. And it's not like they don't pay like they used to either.
And it's the same smaller clubs, and it's like, I'm not loving it like I used to.
Right.
You know?
Right.
Yeah, you've outgrown it.
It's a new time for you to do a new adventure.
That's like if you do more in wrestling, your body's going to
crash.
You're going to be in a wheelchair.
The only slam I get is if a spirit slams me.
That's why I do actually see you do running a camp, maybe for a summer, maybe for whatever, you know, like underprivileged children or whatever, which I think would be really good for you, because it would give you that wonderful feeling of accomplishment, because you really haven't had any closure on the field that you were in for so many years.
I kind of have. I really never thought of a... I thought of a camp years ago, like I said, but it was a lot of money involved.
Yeah.
But
you will find a... Or you may be running a camp, you know, having somebody sponsor it, but you will. Because you still, when you believe in it, you still need that closure.
Well, we'll see what happens. We'll see what the future
brings. Now, I'll believe in it for you. How's that?
That's fine. That's okay.
Okay. Yeah. Right? We'll believe in it for you, right?
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
Of course.
You know, never a doubt. What do you think? Because he still needs that.
Maybe I'll run a woman's camp.
I do think you need a closure.
I can run a woman's camp.
You could do that.
And you can be the teacher.
Woman's camp? Oh, you're talking about nudity. All right.
Jello wrestling.
There you go. So, do you have a website?
We're still working on that. It's.
You were working on that 6 months ago or a year ago.
You know what I do every night? I edit. I have so much footage from these last couple of adventures that we've been on. I do that every night. That's all I'm doing. Yeah. You know, unfortunately, these guys don't have the equipment, and they can't help me with this, and that's okay. And that's my job, and I want this to be successful. And so I'm dedicating every spare minute I can.
First of all, you would never allow anybody else to edit it but you.
I'm getting better at this, aren't I, though?
Yeah, he's...
Okay. I'm allowing them to bring their...
But you're going to have the final say, trust me.
Bingo. Yeah. That I won't let go. This was my dream before anybody was around. Yeah. Right. And I feel that I own it in that I've got
like
some...
Well, it's like here. You know, we agree on things here, but obviously if I have the final say, but still we agree on everything going on.
Yeah.
We've never really had that much disagreement, have we?
Nope.
No, we've not. Because there are a couple of things I want to do, but I don't do because out of respect for her. And after I think it over, and I realize, this is going to hurt. It really is, trust me. And I think it over, and it hurts me in a minute.
Yeah, when we first started this, I was like, "You guys are killing me. This is the way it's got to be." Then these guys are here for a reason. I believe that the three of us are gonna make something really good out of this, and that, you know, we all have creativity within us.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, I'm sad that he couldn't make it.
Yeah, he's an artist and he teaches, and Wednesdays unfortunately is one of his nights, big nights.
Well, I thought maybe because that's just something that's growing by the herd.
She supports him all the way. Huh? She supports him all the way with us.
That's wonderful.
Yeah. He just made a change.
See, that's the biggest part of your anything, that any project that we do. My son's wife supported her all the way, and Scott supports her. You know, if you got that family support, that is probably 90% of the battle.
I think so. It just makes it so much easier.
Believe me, my wife has done everything to help me, my motocross career. I mean, she was there when we didn't have the money for the new bike. We found a way all through her. And I'll tell you, thank you, Jody. Just got to say that.
How long you been together?
about 38 years. Oh my God. Counting, we lived together for a couple of years and then get married. And it's been a long time. And
I went through this period, all of them there. If I had stayed married to Mike's mother, it would have been 45 years that I shut her. My other wife, I'd been married almost 50 years, and I shut her on that one. The other two, I just don't even bother to count anymore, yeah. You know.
Wow. That's a lot of years.
I have a detached personality, according to my psychologist.
That really?
I went to. I love people when they're around, when I don't show emotions or love or anything like that. But I'm happy, and this is who I am, you know. And you've been married a long time, too?
We've been together for 12 years.
Okay.
So.
Well, you live together, right?
Yeah, 12
so
years.
I call that a marriage.
Well, we just got married.
Oh, you did? Congratulations. Yeah. When did you get married?
That,
oh, boy, are you in trouble.
December. December 19th.
Oh, boy, are you in trouble. You heard that.
No, we got married December 19th, but we're going back to Vegas to do it again because she's always wanted to get married in Vegas. So we're going back in July.
My good invitation in the mail?
Yeah. Okay. But we got to tell you a story.
Uh-oh.
About the ring.
Go ahead.
At the Houghton Mansion, when we went there, we did all the stuff. And down in the basement where Laura's spirit lives.
Little girl.
Little girl. They have toys all over the place. So we're trying to get her attention by putting the flashlight on. She turns it off and on, plays little games with us. So we're down here for a little while. Then we went upstairs to take a break or whatever we did. We're sitting here talking. You know, a lot of times you sit there and you play. All of a sudden, my ring's gone. I'm like, I started panicking. I'm like, it's a huge house. Where do we go to look for the ring?
So we're out all night and he comes home with no wedding ring.
So it's like.
Yeah.
And I had no clue. I'm like, wow. So I tell everybody, we got to go look for the ring. And Rich found it down by the toys.
Walked right to it.
The flash.
That was the weird thing.
He saw
that
the flash.
That little girl wanted you to find it there.
By the way,
could I give you a suggestion on when you're spiritually? Invite them to have a cup of coffee with you.
Really?
Show them that you are their friend. Now, this isn't me talking. I know it sounds like me, but this is the spirit actually telling me to give you advice. And I know nothing about it, nor do I even want to know about it. But my spirit is telling me to invite them a cup of coffee with you. You know, bring your coffee down and sit with them. And before you start to send them all, just sit there and feel their energy.
Yes.
Does it make sense to you?
Yeah, a lot of the experienced ghost hunters, for lack of a better word, will go and do that. They'll sit in that energy and just get a feel for it before they try to engage.
Yeah, and be friendly with them.
Yeah, I mean, we're wide open to suggest because, you know, we're obviously new at this. And
one of the houses that you're going to, like the one in Hampton Falls, and that's what they call it, Hampton Falls.
Yeah.
So does it fall down, or is there a river that falls in it, or whatever? I've never been there, so,
We've never been there.
Dunkin' Donut coffee. I have no idea, but take a Dunkin' Donut coffee with you.
Does it have to be Dunkin' Donuts? They're expensive.
Yep. I'll buy.
Can
I go to McDonald's for a dollar?
It's better coffee.
Had corrosion. Actually, Starbucks is better.
Yeah, but McDonald's is better than Dunkin' Donuts.
Yeah. Oh, I do
McDonald's
like McDonald's.
Newman's, right?
Absolutely, I love.
Well, some of them do.
Yeah, I well
not nationwide.
Yeah, I do like McDonald's coffee.
Yeah, for a buck,
but I can't. But I can't go in there.
He got banned from McDonald's.
Yeah, I got
all of them.
Yeah,
every McDonald's.
Just about.
What'd you do? Eat too many burgers?
No, I told them they were all retarded.
Oh, okay.
They didn't have a sense of humor.
They didn't?
No. Well, when I go in, I ask for a cheeseburger, okay, and that lady asked me four times if I want cheese on a cheeseburger. That's a little annoying.
Yeah.
She said, no, I'll have a hamburger.
And I said, so without thinking, I said, are you retarded or what? All of a sudden, the manager comes over. Well, I don't see anything wrong with that question. I said, well, you're just as retarded as they are.
Oh, my.
That's the one in Goffstown.
Oh, yeah.
But I do sneak into the one on Hanover Street in Manchester. That's a nice one. And it's clean. You know, that's what I like.
Yeah.
But and really, take a whether it's a good order, what really, because you're actually, the spirit of that house loves that smell of that coffee.
Really?
I love the smell of coffee.
Yeah. I do too.
I
cut back a lot on coffee, but then I forget it. See, but actually, do you know that coffee is actually very good for men over 40?
Really?
And it prevents prostate cancer, according to the latest research.
Oh, really?
But black coffee.
That's all I drink.
Once you start putting sugar and cream and stuff in it, you're taking any good because coffee, black coffee is very good for everybody.
We mix ours half decaf, half regular.
Oh, we do that too.
Yeah, and
you know how they make the decaf?
How?
We check out on it. They need to formaldehyde it.
Oh. Not all of them, but yeah, some of the companies do that. Starbucks, I don't believe, does.
No. Oh. Starbucks and okay. Well, anyways, folks, for one moment, we're going to go. Then we're going to play your tape. I want to read off what we got here coming up for the events. Okay, we got a second event. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
Turn the light on.
There you go. Look at it. Look at it go.
There it goes.
Thank you, Laura.
It was home of a very influential family in North Adams. They wanted to go out for just a leisurely car ride on you know, a morning. They left at 9, and by 9:30, tragedy had already struck. It's really unfortunate. But the thing to remember about this house is it's not a demonic possession. It's not something scary. It's a story, and it's a place where the people who live there, the
Sorry about that.
Well, actually, if you look at it this way, maybe the spirit didn't want you to show it on us.
No, it's all over YouTube right now. So,
they want people to go and support you on YouTube.
Yeah,
clearly.
Great.
Is it on YouTube?
Yeah.
You know, a lot of times that's what happens, and a lot of times in you know, they wanted to happen there because maybe that, you know, because I've said a lot of things that I say, so that's, well, we're not going to give you the pleasure of watching it or whatever. No. So there, I'll just go on YouTube, Laura. How do you like me now? But
I wouldn't piss her off. She might be a nice little girl, but.
Yeah, but no. That's what people don't realize, but it could be a malfunction or whatever, but we can try it again later if you want.
We'll see. I mean, I think, you know, the biggest thing out of that was we got some responses. Every room we went to, we got responses.
Now, is that the one with Colleen?
No.
Oh.
This is the whole mansion, North Adams, Mass, out in the Berkshires, beautiful place. We had great caretakers there that really knew the mansion well, knew the spirits well, and able to guide us through this. They asked a lot of the questions.
Okay.
Okay. Sure, go for it.
Yep.
Their home really loved their town. They really loved each other, and we should bring that in with us, you know.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. I mean, that time period, you know, the turn of the century, you know, new things are happening all the time, families together, you know, it's a little different than it is nowadays, you know. So, yeah, we're looking forward to going to this house, you know, see what this family's all about, and we're going to have some fun. It's going to be great. Great trip coming up.
It's going to be a long night, so be prepared, guys.
Hi, this is Rich Damboise, host of Adventurecam. Join me, along with my co-hosts Jerry the Candyman Seavey, Marcel Prue, and Kristen Witten, as we travel through the Berkshires to investigate the Houghton Mansion in North Adams, Mass. Here, we'll learn the story of A.C. Houghton, founder and first mayor of North Adams. What started out as a pleasure cruise to Vermont in the family's new 1914 Pierce Arrow ended in tragedy when the chauffeur John Witters tried to avoid a work crew, sending the vehicle down a steep embankment. In the car, along with Witters and Houghton, Racy's eldest daughter Mary, Mary's childhood friend Sybil, and Sybil's husband Dr. Robert Hutton of New York. All of the men appeared to escape with minor injuries. Sybil died almost instantly, and Mary died later that afternoon. So distraught was Witters that he took his own life early the next morning. A.C. Houghton died 11 days later. Could it be undiagnosed injuries or a broken heart? We may never know.
Thank you.
This is beautiful.
Wow. Unbelievable. The whole neighborhood's gorgeous. Look at these old Victorians. And there's beautiful houses all along here. Very picturesque, beautiful town. So we're in for a long night. We're going to have some fun here. You guys ready for this?
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Ready.
Holton Mansion and North Adams Bass, and we're ready for one long night.
Let's do this.
Let's do it, guys.
The Houghton Mansion is located on Church Street, among many other beautiful historic homes. Mr. Houghton selected this area as it was the most prominent real estate in North Adams at the time. He also commissioned one of the top architects, H. Neil Wilson, to design his new home, which was completed in 1897. A.C. Houghton, along with being a prominent business owner and politician, was also an active member in the Masons, so it seems fitting that the property was sold to the five area Masonic lodges in 1927. Construction on the attached Masonic temple was started in May of 1928 and completed in spring of 1929. This gives us a lot of property to explore, so let's go inside.
Is there anything you want to say to us before we leave?
Yes. Yes.
Could you tell us your name?
Okay, we have to go. We'll talk soon.
Whoa. Wow. They're both going.
Mine's not doing anything over here.
Look at that.
I know it.
Don't be upset.
No, I'm not upset. It's like...
No, but he's not talking shit.
No, it's like...
Want to say something? Go ahead, say it. Go ahead.
Can you talk? Make a sound?
Serious?
Well, both of them are going haywire.
Wow. There's something you want to say? Can you tell us?
They're both in sync, too, almost.
Oh, yeah. They both at the same time.
Has this ever happened before? It has, huh?
Wow.
Look at him. See him? Look at him.
Both.
Oh.
Wow.
Put on a little show for us?
For a few minutes, we continued to watch for more signs galore, but we had a lot left to explore, so we then headed to a small room in the Masonic Temple where a spirit decided to have some fun with Marcel.
It was you.
How was you doing that?
Spirit.
Can you make the flashlight roll?
I'd like to hear you make that noise again.
Can you make that noise, please? Can you put that light on up there?
Yeah, that noise.
Yeah.
What was that?
Yeah, it's like a pop.
No, I'm telling you, I'm not making any noise. I'm so quiet as a church mouse. See? He's even agreeing with me later on.
Church mouse? Why did they say that?
I don't know.
Because they're quiet.
Have you ever heard of church mouse?
Exactly.
Not lately.
There you go.
I'm not in a church long enough.
You like this light. Can you turn the other one on?
Can you point it in Marcel's eyes?
Thank you.
There you go. Okay, right in my eyes, right too. He listened to you.
Wow. Gosh. Pretty good at that. Can you
pretty
turn
strong,
it on,
too?
Thank you.
That's too bright for Marcel over there. Can you turn that one down?
That's pretty cool.
Wow.
Can you turn this one off right here?
Thank you for doing that. You can shut it off now. I don't want you to blind the poor guy. Because if it's in his eyes long enough, or anybody's, you start seeing spots.
There goes one. There goes the other.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
Appreciate
it very much.
Do you like communicating with us? Are we easy to get along with?
His battery's almost dead.
Yeah. You keep hearing a noise. I don't know if it's clicking.
Popping. Yeah.
I don't know. What did I hear the sound? I'm not hearing.
That's an outside wall behind that.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's, and you're up on the second floor, so it's not somebody out there banging on the wall.
Right.
You know, no, it could
no,
be.
There's no gap. There's no trees or anything like that. I don't know what that noise is.
If you look out the window, see somebody looking at you.
If you made that noise, could you shut the light off? So we know.
Could you turn that other light on again like I asked you earlier that you did? One more time, please. Then we'll get out of your hair.
What if it doesn't get there?
We'll get off your back. Please. You proved it to us once, you can do it again.
Yes, just turn the other light on.
One more time, then we'll bail on out. We're asking you nicely. Pretty please.
And we asked him to put it in my eyes again. He would do it.
All right, go ahead. Point it in his eyes again. He asked for it, I didn't. Thank you very much.
He doesn't like Marcel much.
Oh, boy.
He doesn't like me?
No.
Or he likes messing with you.
Yeah.
That's okay.
He might like you.
Maybe you remind him of somebody.
Well, do I remind you of somebody?
That you don't like?
You have to add that part.
You don't want that, right?
Wow, that's very cool.
Oh, yeah.
Did you still... Was any of this rehearsed?
No. Nothing.
Nothing.
Was this all genuine?
Oh, of course, yeah, and that's what that's we when we look at other shows.
Put the mic a little bit. Put your chair up to the mic.
When we look at the other shows, they react to a little bump, a little, and they're all, oh my God.
Yeah.
We just wanted to go in and see for ourselves, what is going on? Is this real? We don't know. Well, I'll tell you, when I walked away from that, I'm definitely a believer now, and it was amazing.
I was watching that, and you know, as much as I don't like what goes on, the respect that you people have for you have Grant, and it doesn't mean much probably, but you have my utmost respect for that.
Well, thank you for that.
Normally, friends will respect that, don't you agree?
Oh, absolutely.
When you touched the flashlights, did it feel cold, did it feel hot, or what was the...
No, because generally when we first walk into a room, that's when we get them all set and we loosen them up a little bit and then just put them down. And then we walk away, then we start asking questions.
Yeah.
We let them know that on for yes, you know, off for no. Sometimes we have to remind them to shut it off so we can ask another question. But it was amazing the amount of questions that were answered. And I talked about Witters at the beginning of the show, that the man killed himself. He was so distraught. He was the chauffeur. 1914 cars were brand new. He went off the road heading to Vermont, and he felt so bad because they were all so close. Actually, his grave is in the same site as the family. That's how close everybody was. Mm. But when we started asking questions to him, he was just answering us one after another, and it seemed like every room we went into, this was going on for us. And I actually got a message from the caretakers that they tried to recreate the same amount of activity that we got in the boiler room, especially.
Yeah.
They couldn't get it to happen. So it was just maybe the combination of us. I don't know what it was.
Well, number one, the key thing was, I always remember that you went in there with respect. You didn't go in there with a, I'm going to get this spirit to talk to me or whatever. And you went in there with a real grateful or very humble attitude. And that, to me, is probably why I'm willing to believe, and then I said, well, believe that you are probably the only ones that have ever got the most out of the spirits in their house. Wow. And I'm usually pretty right on stuff like this. How do you feel about that?
I don't understand your question.
Okay. In other words, if others Dope Center like, went in, and I don't see them getting the same respect or the same reception that these people are getting.
Well, I think, I mean, I'm not 100% sure, but I think I saw when Ghost Hunters went in and did that house. And they did catch quite a bit.
Yeah.
But I think the difference here is he felt that you would tell his story. Because he's often overshadowed by the family. Mm-hmm. And for whatever reason, he trusted you guys to tell his story. And that's why he was speaking with you so much. Wow. The caretakers, he knows they have a job to do.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So he doesn't feel that same level trust with them that he did with you guys.
They're just doing their job, but we're there trying to communicate with them. And so they're just communicating
right.
back.
And not only
you
that.
You highlighted him.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
didn't
yeah.
You? You know,
so you glorified him and not you.
Yeah.
See, when you do, and like I used to glorify myself when I had my show. I mean, I was the egomaniac. I had the show, and I mean, I wouldn't do psychically. I wouldn't talk to other people at any events. I would have to be by myself until I looked in the mirror and the spirit told me what I didn't like to hear. But as people like you, and I will say this over and over, people like you, that makes our show the way it is today. And it's people that our viewing audience have often said that anyway. Lori, we are only the tools that want people to be known. See, this is what I like about my show. We're not one of the political, war garbage. The Democrats are going to destroy this one, and the Republicans are going to destroy this because they ate too much chocolate, they had diarrhea from the mouth from it, or whatever, you know. And we are here to bring out a different type of show. People who care. Like, you two really do care about what you... Do you want the glory? Of course you do. You're human. Do you have an ego? If you don't have an ego, you're not going to go anywhere. But it depends on how you handle the ego.
Yeah.
Jerry had an ego. I've had an ego. We all... If you... And you had an ego when you... If we... When you were a bike rider, right? Mm-hmm. You had an ego, right?
Yeah, sure.
If you don't have an ego, then you know what? It depends on how you handle your ego. And
it's
all...
Cool. You have to use it as a tool, not let it use you.
Yeah. The confidence and ego, I guess, are very similar.
Do you have an airplane license? Pilot's license?
No, but I just got a drone license. So.
Yeah, but do you have a pilot license?
No.
You're getting one.
Really? I just registered with the FAA because of the drone.
Yeah.
Maybe that.
So you can invite our you can invade our privacy then.
I would never do that, though.
How do we know?
You don't. You have to trust me. I'm a nice guy.
How do I know?
You could ask me.
How would I ever? Yeah.
I'll back him up.
He's a nice guy. Trust me.
No, but it's. But I mean, I know you wouldn't do it, but you know, and I know that people they are going to abuse it,
and
that's the sad part.
No matter what,
the government does it already.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? They say UPS and FedEx is going to be delivering products through drone.
Yeah.
That's scary. But now your product breaks or whatever,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
But
this guy's going to get a little crowded out there too.
Yeah.
Yeah. People should be against because there are too many drones kind of get in the way of the airplanes that are there.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's certain rules, like we can't go above 400 feet. My drone will not go in a no-fly zone. It's programmed so it won't. I'm respectful for other people's property without that, so I would not do the same thing with a drone.
Right.
You know? I just want to get a different vision for us, a different view.
Right.
Like, the building, you know? Yeah.
It's actually pretty cool.
Yeah,
he could have had
that
sitting
there. A couple of young girls, you know, like 34, 35, nice hot-looking bodies. He's going to drone in there taking a shower or whatever to bring it back.
The fifth floor.
And on the fifth floor.
I can see him doing that.
Yeah. Fault I'm going to do
I don't
it.
Have one,
only
so I
kidding.
Can't.
You know, we have to be careful how we handle things.
You can take it to Vegas, bring
yeah.
it up.
Yeah. Hey, there you go. You know, I went to Metro PC yesterday, Scott and I did with my daughter-in-law, and we got a couple of nice cell phones for going on their line, you know, not two for the price of one, so to speak, in their lines. And I really got a compliment. I got to put my glasses on here. Katie and Jay. They were really very, they really cared about how to take care of it. When you find a lot of people don't, but yeah. They really bent over backwards to please us. We got every, well, I should say bent over backwards, but anyways, but they got, you know, they really were very nice to us, and they really treated us with respect. And there was one guy in there, and they were funny, and then me and Jay treated them with patience, and he was really nice to them. I really want to compliment them. People that are on Amory Street, right near the fire department. If you need a new phone line, go to Metro PC, I would tell you to go on to Amory Street, and they will show you a lot of respect. Whether they watch the show or not, I'm still, I kept my word on it, and I need to. Well, are we that boring today?
It's catchy.
You know,
she's tired.
I am very tired today.
And I want to thank them for their kindness, and they gave us a lot of good discounts. And actually, I found it was a lot cheaper than what I was getting for, I would buy prepaid cards.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you get cheated out of 2 days. I went paying $60 a month for a prepay and told me it would be expiring on the 10th, and it would actually expire on the 8th.
Oh.
So that upset me a little bit too, you know. And so far, everything's really, I just have to learn how to do the, you know, these new fangled buddies, these new spang dangle things that go on. You know, you got to learn them all over.
What, 34? You should be all over that.
I know, but my body says no. And I'm not stoned when I do it, so.
That's usually helpful.
Yeah. And now we are going to be, we got a big event coming up. Unfortunately, you can't make it, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. Where are you going to be?
Autograph signing.
Oh, good
in
for
Boston.
You. Good for you. Okay. So we're going to, you want to do it, you want me to?
You got your glasses.
Oh. Okay. Folks, readers and vendors for Norm and Friends Spring Annual Psychic Event, April 9th at the Unitarian Universalist Church at 669 Union Street in Manchester from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. We're going to have as readers, we got a lot of them. Norm, hi. And Lori, no, Sherry, is it Cheryl or Sherry?
Well, Cheryl is her formal name. Her friends call her Sherry.
Sherry. And she's going to be tuning forks and all that. Have you ever had that done, the tuning? I would recommend it.
That was amazing.
She did it here on my show.
What is that all about?
And she takes a tuning fork and bats you in the head.
No, she balances your energy with a tuning fork.
Yeah.
She can feel where things are out of whack. And
yeah, I would tell you to go and have her check it out. She's really excellent. I haven't had a back problem since.
She can do my back?
Yeah.
Wow.
Always or one. I mean, but no, she does really good. I really recommend that. Mm-hmm. And then Pauline Hathorn is going to be coming. She's a car reader. I'm teaching her how my way of doing it. Catherine Seavey said it's confirmed she is going to be coming.
She does the automatic writing.
Yeah, she does the automatic writing. Right. Susie, how do you pronounce her?
Marat.
Marat is going to be there. Then we got Carrie Milton, who does the stone readings. And she was really phenomenal. Really phenomenal there. We got Genevieve Hackett, a card reader. We got Cindy Stewart. She's okay. She's a newbie but knows it all, but that's okay.
She was really good, too.
Yeah.
She was really good.
We got Dawn Drew. We're going to be sending prayers out to her because she had open-heart surgery. I'm very concerned about her health and all that stuff because she's really wearing herself out to a frazzle, so we have to ask her prayers on that. We got a new one, Carol Clary. She does angel card readings, too. And then I don't know a lot about this, Dr. Tony. Do you know anything?
I don't know much about Dr. Tony either, other than he works with Cheryl.
Right. And then we got Dr. Kevin Ross Emery. Did I get it right? Coming in as a reader, Ray Wilm. I'm going to put his name in a little bit of headlights. That'll make him feel better. You know, you and I don't need that ego, but you know. And because he has a huge following.
He does have a huge following.
So we'll do, then we get the show. How do you tell you on?
Right. Sure.
Whatever, you know, massage of the oils, that's a vendor. We got Bob Whitebeard Olson, he plays the flute. You remember him being there.
Amazing flute.
We got Demi Walls, who has the fairy tales. I mean, the fairy doors and gifts. Jeff Travis, who sells candles, natural soaps.
Natural skincare. Yeah, he does have some candles, but he has natural skincare.
And Chris Gately confirmed. If that's what you got.
Chair massage.
He does chair massage.
Hopefully, I'll get one
there
this time.
Yeah. There's some group called the Adventurecam that's going to be there.
Adventurecam?
Yeah, Adventurecam.
That sounds vaguely familiar. Yeah, no, like, I've heard of them.
Have you ever
heard of them?
They're really cool guys.
Are they really?
They're really cool.
Going skyrocket.
I like it.
Oh, okay.
I like it.
And then we got, as far as I know, we got Linda and Goodwin coming in. She sells crystals. Merrimack, right?
I'm not sure where Linda lives.
One of them, okay. Bruce Hodgkins said he's going to be there. We got Matt Connington, who does hypnosis. He's going to be that. April can't make it.
Elaine Saunders will be there.
Yeah, Elaine Saunders. She's the matchmaker. Lizzie Logan, as far as I know. Mary LeMay. Then we got a new one, Lisa Mishkin.
Leslie.
Leslie Munchin.
Minchin.
She does jewelry as well. And I have an Emma. I got past her name somewhere here. Oh yeah, Emma Moran, she does crystal jewelry, so that's been confirmed, she pays. And then, for the people that are coming on to the event.
Onto the show, you mean?
Yeah, I mean on the show. Right. Sorry about that, folks. We got, where the hell are we? That's today, okay, we got the Adventurecam. Next week, we got Pauline Hathworth and
Michaela
St. George coming on. Rose, I didn't even try to pronounce her last name. And we got a whole lot of new people. We're right up until all of June. Well, we got June 8th. No, not June 8th. It's going to be interesting because Dawn Drew and Chris Gately are going to be coming on, and they're going to interview us instead of us interviewing them.
Really?
Yeah, I think that'll be interesting. Oh. June 29th. I'm sorry. I don't know who I have on June 8th. I haven't got that yet. We got Susan Morgan coming in on the 22nd. But October 19th, if people can really get into this, we got a family out of some town.
Pelham.
That this young girl, she settled up when she was 14, and her family were really dire need.
They lost everything. Everything.
But they didn't think of themselves. They built a haunted trail to raise money to go and get names off of the Christmas tree to help the less fortunate. This young girl, she was only 14 when she started it, and this is like her fourth, and it's a family endeavor now.
Wow.
Okay, so they're gonna be coming on. I wanted to, you know, to promote it. And you know, it goes to show you that not all kids, if people are, these kids, people like that, you know, it makes you know that they're doing something worthwhile. You know, when you see kids do some kind of charity work, like Susan, I didn't even try to pronounce her, Bryce Steiner, her son is doing something with the American flag or building up some kind of a pole or something like that, and then he wants to do other things. And folks, and then he did a lot of cooking for the bake sale we had.
Yes, he did.
He really did. And if you could bring some homemade, have you always make something or you make something, you know, that would be awesome. Okay. But it shows you, you know what? There's a lot of hope in this generation still. When you see all these kids and they are helping each other, like I see a lot, and the one thing that I'm excited about is when I look into the park, I see more and more fathers involved in with their children. You know, and I think that you have a good relationship with your children.
Oh, right? Yeah, awesome, yeah.
And you do too, right? Yes. Smack her around a little bit.
Even though she don't live around here, she lives up in Farmington, New Hampshire, so.
But you still communicate with her.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. You know, that's
only when she wants money.
No, I know that. But still, you love her anyway.
Of course I do.
You know,
it's my little girl.
How old is she?
32.
No, well, yeah, we're pretty. Oh yeah, and how old are yours?
33 and 34.
And you have grandchildren, right?
Yeah, I got two grandsons that I miss so much. One was 10 minutes away, now is 10 hours away.
Aww.
Or at least at North Carolina, which I may be going there when I retire.
Actually, no, your youngest grandson is going to follow Grandpa's footsteps.
Yeah?
Yeah. He's going to be the daredevil of the family.
Wow.
Okay. Because he has a lot of respect for you.
Yeah.
And also, and that's like, I'm very fortunate, my son, I mean, he's been through hell and back with me. You know, we've had days we've been poverty or whatever. And I'm very fortunate, very blessed to have a son that I, you know, that we support each other. And my beautiful, I call my daughter-in-law my guardian angel.
Wow.
The only thing she does, she tells the doctors everything I do. You know? And then I have a beautiful granddaughter whom I adore, you know.
Yeah.
And you have children, right?
Yes, I do.
And you're the love of your life.
Absolutely.
You have how many? 10?
two. Two children. Two children, four grandchildren.
Okay. But they all sort of love your life.
Oh, absolutely.
And, you know, this is the whole thing, folks. When we talk, we're not just talking. What's our children are important to us. Are they not?
Kids are the future.
They sure are. And if you can, you know, look at them. And don't be afraid to give them a hug. Don't be afraid to tell them I'm proud of you. Even if they do something wrong, still let them know you love them. My favorite saying used to be, I'll love you, reward you when you're good, but I have to love you and correct you or punish you, you know, when you're bad. You know, there are consequences to everything. You know, the ABC thing, right?
Oh, yeah.
And that's all you got to do. It's just let your children know that you love them.
With my kids, I would get very upset if they did anything wrong, and it would scare them. Never had to hit them or anything.
Oh, I don't believe it, man.
But I'll tell you, when everything calmed down, I come back and talk to them, like, this is why, and they respect that. And they told me later on in life that they really respect that I would come back and say, this is why I'm so upset, this is the reasons about it. And it was a very good relationship we've had, you know, all of our lives.
Nice.
You know, I met a person that I have never been so nervous or so scared of talking with in my life, and doing a reading on. Usually I'm pretty collective, okay? And I'll tell you right now, I did a lot of grounding. Believe me, I've heard a lot of sage. And she came in, and I said, why do you want to go to jail? She is facing 28 years, three suspended sentences right now. She gets caught again. Wow. I'm not going to go into a big detail on it, but it's her son is selling drugs around the school, and her boyfriend is illegally here, and this scares me, because instead of allowing her son to do this, she should be saying, no, this is not a proper thing to be doing, you know. Turn it around. I've offered that in here. Turn it around. Instead of doing the negative, let's teach it into a positive. That's what's right. Happening. Don't allow, and so many of them, well, I'm going to go send them off to daycare or pre-K, preschool. Is that what they call it?
Preschool.
Head Start. Then they go to kindergarten. Then they go to school. Then they go to Boys and Girls Club. A lot of it, I agree that they have to work two or three jobs, but a lot of it's an easy way out. And teachers are not babysitters. You agree with that?
Mm-hmm.
Teachers are not your babysitters. They're trying to help you to learn. It's up to you. Yeah. We've talked about this many times.
Mm-hmm.
After a while, it gets boring, but that's okay. But I can't express enough how we've got to look at our children and say, we love you. You know, do you have a good relationship with your parents, right?
Oh, very good, yes. I'm blessed. I with my family, you know, from my parents to my children to my grandchildren, I hit the jackpot.
Well, look at the positives coming out of all that. You have your own adventure camp. Yeah, I got it right.
You did.
And that's a big word.
It is.
I got it. But that is. And how about? And you lived a lot of your dream.
Correct.
Yeah, but did you have a lot of? Did you have a lot of support with it?
No.
No.
Not by my. Well, my brother. That's it.
Yeah.
But my father, not too much. He didn't want me to do it.
He wanted to be a big businessman.
No, he just said, "Be who you are, not who you want to be."
Well, who you were was?
He said, you don't want to go in the ring, be bounced around like a dummy and blah, blah, blah.
He was afraid. He was afraid for you.
Yeah, maybe he was, but I didn't listen to him.
No.
Because if I did, I just wouldn't be who I was.
Right.
Or who I am.
And this is the way I feel about what I do today. I always feel as I didn't know who my mother was because she passed away as a baby. My dad was here and there. But I tried to visualize what it had been like if I'd had both parents. Mm. And I saw a picture of what it had been like. And I didn't like what I saw. I can't picture me working in a factory, ruining my nails. God, it costs so much to get your nails done, doesn't it? It costs a lot of money, you know. If mother for like my foster mother, I had an awesome foster mother, you know. But it was on a path that I need to be on to be where I am today. If we all realize, like, you getting bounced around the ring, and having you dislocated several times, and you
know it was broken.
Yeah. You do get hurt, don't you?
Oh, my sternum broken.
Yeah.
I'm all screwed up now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But you would do it again.
But I would. I mean, I'd go back this weekend in the ring because I love it. I enjoy the excitement with the people screaming my name. It's a great feeling.
Do they ever forget it's supposed to be just, you know, like a play? They actually hurt each other?
Do they what?
Do they really punch each other?
They slap you, but they don't punch, unless it's an accident, unless it slips. Yeah. But they'll, you know, they really slap you. Yeah. If they hit you with a chair, they really hit you because they don't want it to look too fake. So they got to, you know, try to make contact with the chair. Yeah,
we had a friend named Wacko. Now he's a bodyguard for Godsmack, Sully there.
Yeah.
He's a bodyguard for him. And he's come to my house. He'd tell me some of the, he says the jealousy that is incredible. And they all have eagles. They all want to be starred. And he said, the jealousy. Is there a lot of?
Oh, you should see what goes on in the dressing room. There's a lot of fights back there because they'll have one guy that thinks he's better than one guy. Well, if one guy comes in, like he's new, and one guy's been in it for 5 years, and the other guy comes in, he's been in a month, and all of a sudden they bring this guy to the top, and they're like, why are you bringing him to the top? I've been in 5 years. Well, he's bringing in the crowd. You're blah, blah, blah. And they'll start fighting, and they start hollering, and it's all real. It's, you know, there's a lot of shit, excuse me, there's a lot of stuff garbage. That goes on. Yeah. A lot of garbage that goes on in the dressing room.
Do they bring it to the ring, though?
No. I've seen fights at the Boston Guide when I was there. Like, a couple of wrestlers, I don't know if I said this before when I was on the show. Like Vince would say, these two guys would be going up against each other, and he said, you're going to lose, you're going to win. This guy would, I'm not losing this match, I'm 6'10". This guy's only 6'. He goes, and Vince would be like, you're losing if you don't like it too bad. And he says, swearing at him, I quit, and he walked out. Then I remember one time the Ultimate Warrior come flying in, smacked Vince in the face, and says, you screwed me out of my action figures, which how true it was, I have no clue. And he walked out. There's a lot of stuff that goes on. You'd be surprised.
And then they get the Ultimate Warrior in a Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And what, 2 days later he dies. How sad that is.
It was sad.
I always believe that something with Benoit, I'm not
Chris
saying
Benoit.
I always say there's more to it than we know.
Yeah, nobody knows what really happened.
Money talks, people. Same way with the Canadian there that died in the ring.
Oh, that was Owen Hart.
Owen Hart.
But that was an accident. He didn't want to do it, and the cable supposedly snapped.
Well, he knew, Well, he knew that was his time to go, and he was trying to resist going.
Well, he kept saying, I don't know.
Wasn't he going to retire?
There's a lot of spirits in this building, so.
I think things floating around. It's probably just dust.
No, they do. We had, who was here? Oh, Kevin was here. There was a lot of women around you, a lot of spirits in this. There is a lot of spirits in this building. You would have a good time that they would allow you to bring your machine in here and do that.
Oh, yeah.
One day we were doing the show and a caller called in and asked about the cat that kept walking behind us.
Really?
Really? Wow.
There's no cat.
Yeah.
In the other area where we were, in the back area there before we moved here, there were three women that used to sit in the corner and watch out, and they would supervise us to see if we were going to do it or not. Wow. They've actually had them shut the phone off on us.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
You know, so. Folks, you can believe us or not, you can be skeptical about spirits or whatever, they are real, they are here. You can either respect them or just, it's going to be your choice, okay? I love skeptics, don't you? I really do, because it's our job to prove to them, our position to prove to them that it's real. Like with that show you did. And I have to tell you, the respect that I could feel and I'm talking. Now, if they want to see that whole tape in its entirety, how would they do that?
Probably the easiest way would be, if they're on Facebook, go to Adventurecam's Facebook page, and all the links are there for all our shows, all the updates, what we're doing, sometimes behind the scenes, and that'll bring them right to YouTube, or they go to 2D Designs on YouTube, and that's my channel, and they can see all the stuff there, but everything that we put out now is for that. We're going to be switching that off because a lot of it's my photography is on slideshows, stuff like that, but we're going to be probably splitting that off as things get more popular right now.
So how many episodes of Adventure Cam do you have on
We actually
online?
Have two. I'm working on the third right now. We had one that we were working on at one point. We couldn't get together. It just was not flowing. The Hannah Dustin story that we wanted to put together, we may do a documentary later using a lot of that footage. We didn't have the right equipment. We were still learning, you know, and now you know, with some help from a lot of great people that we've been meeting and running into, we've been able to get some really cool stuff going on, and, you know, now invites to other places. And Jerry's been doing great, keeping us booked. And
oh, my God, don't tell him that. He'll get a big head. He won't be able to go out through the door.
He does have a big head. He's got a forehead.
A high forehead.
Are you, is part of your nationality?
That means I have a lot of
brains. Are you a Native American?
Excuse me?
Are you part Native American?
Yeah. Who said? I mean, how do you know?
Because your nose.
What's wrong with my nose? It was broken.
You have a problem with nose and your forehead tells it. Gives it away.
People thought I was in India when I had a good tan.
You do. Listen. You look very Indian. And
but
also,
I'm Irish and German, though. Yeah.
But you're also, if you look in the background, you would find that you have a lot of Indian heritage about you.
Yeah, probably.
You have one of your spirit guides is a medicine man.
Really?
Wow.
That's nice. I like to know my background.
Okay. You have a Greek mythologist that's your spiritual guide.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's out of the blue there. That
yeah. I know, that's what I'm aware of. Because I've never had anyone come right up before and tell what they actually do. But you are your spiritual, and then he also is helping you with your.
Well, that makes sense because a Greek mythologist would have been a storyteller, a keeper of the myths, and now you're a storyteller, so that makes total sense to me.
And actually, we'll tell you both are on your journey on the right path.
That's
nice. Good to hear.
Okay, you're going to be doing this until you're like 85 years old.
Wow. A couple of years left then, huh?
You'll be having a walker. Honey, bring the key over here. I need my wheelchair. Don't forget my food. I have to sip it through a sippy cup now.
Yeah, I can take...
You have a long life, Jeffrey. So don't you.
Fritz Weatherby's place, maybe when...
Speaking of Weatherby, that guy went on Channel 9?
Yeah,
he's more on, but that's okay.
I love Fritz Weatherby. Yeah. I love him.
I actually see you being interviewed by him.
Really?
There's something about, he's going to talk about the house at the falls, what do you call it, Gun Falls?
Hampton Falls?
Oh, Hampton Falls. Yeah. Let me try that.
The governor's mansion.
Let me tell you about what happened here.
I love
it. You know, we've sent letters after letters after letters to Channel 9 and no response.
The reason why is because they're jealous of what you have.
Well, they should give us I like to have a big break to go on there, you know. It would be nice just to interview us.
They wouldn't even recognize Al Caprillion.
It's tough to get on Chronicle, I think.
Yeah.
Well, but Tommy was on it.
Yeah, so was Barb. So was Ann Deirdre. But
when the time
still.
Is right, you know, you will, well, don't give up. Actually, you're going on the WBZ on Channel 4, which is a lot bigger.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Stop doubting yourselves, both of you.
Well, I don't.
When the time is right, Rich, when the time is right, you're going to go. They're going to do a big documentary. You're going on like Channel 39. I believe that's one of the travel stations. Do not be discouraged. See, so many people there's so many out there, but they want the genuine. They want the real. I have a very good friend, Jeff Kimball. He was doing it. He kept trying, you know, doing travel and travel. He and I would go into debates because I would get him going to, I don't believe in what he's doing. Okay. But for some reason, I'm going to turn that around only with you two. Because the reason why I'm saying that is you're not just walking in there uninvited. You're walking in there invited by whomever lives there. And you're also respecting the building, the earth, the light, whatever. Mm-hmm. And like when you had the flashlights and you picked up the flashlights after it was all over, were they hot, warm, were there any different feeling? Were there any different energy?
I didn't notice anything different.
I didn't notice
it. The only thing we noticed was cold was at the Victorian Mansion, the S.K. Pierce in Gardner, Mass. There were some cold spots in there that were, we went in there, it was very cold, no heat in the building. Yeah. And you know the cold spell we've had, it was one of those times. Mm. It was so cold, but it was a different kind of cold. It was that one spot we were all like, wow, we could feel it. You could feel it moving. Mm. It wasn't like a draft thing. It was just, it was amazing. It just, you know, none of this was scary. None of this felt bad. It was all, wow. That's all I could feel was, this is amazing.
You know what? Another thing that I'm looking at it too is when you love what you're doing.
Yeah,
that makes the big difference. Yeah. Too, people go in there and you gotta enjoy and you gotta love what you're doing. You order, like, I love this show. It may never be number one content, and I don't want to be. You know, I'm happy when, if I ever got any ratings, I'm happy if I did this. I love what I'm doing, you know, and this is the whole game. You both do, and it's fun, it's enjoyable. You're also got another permanent woman that's going to be coming on with you, but be very careful of who you select as a communicator, as a that will can do communication with mediums. Be very careful who you select, because it could mess up your whole entire creation.
Yeah, and I don't think it's somebody you've already worked with.
No, I don't either.
I will tell you that much right now.
Okay.
Well, you know who we had last time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Colleen. Yeah. No, this lady has like white blonde hair.
No, she did. I'm sure she did great. But this is someone that's going to become a permanent member of your group.
Really?
And it's going to be, your wife is actually going to be the one to find it for you.
Really?
Oh, she's going to keep a close tab on your hoo-hoo, let me tell you. But actually, I do see them, but actually, because there's going to be a lot of people, a lot of mediums that are going to want to come and work with you people.
Really? Yeah, because I feel you guys are really, I mean, you're so close on the verge of taking off. I think somebody's going to come and pick you guys up. And then you'll get all those fancy little toys to play with.
Oh, that'd be amazing. The thing I ask for every day is health and happiness. That's my priorities. No matter what happens, that's all I care about.
And that's why you're getting it, because you're not
looking for no
right. Right, you're not, oh, poor me, my life sucks if I don't get this, you know?
Yeah.
You have your priorities straight.
If I have nothing, as long as I'm happy and healthy, that's my
big dream. What's your next adventure?
Next adventure?
We're going this weekend. Actually, we're going back to both houses just because we were invited. We're going back to the Victorian Mansion and just do a little more videotaping.
Yeah, just a quick video on the outside of the building.
Something had come out right that we filmed. So we're going to do
it. The one that you just saw here?
No.
No, it was the S.K. Pierce. That's the big old Victorian. It's beautiful.
You're going to be doing a whole. No thinking it's going to be on the outside. Don't be surprised if the spirit invites you inside, too.
Yeah, well, we'll see, because we won't be allowed unless, you know, we're, because this is just a quick film on the way to the other place.
Right.
Because we'll go, yeah.
We'll be at the Houghton Mansion.
Because I'm going to tell you, you're going back there again. It may not be right away, but you want, there's going to be, because of the speed, definitely, the one thing, I usually don't, you know, see this, but the spirit or ghost, whatever you want to call them, they like what you're doing, and they want to have fun with you. They want to play games with you. They want to let you know they're around. And one of them is going to do a lot of healing spiritually on you.
Oh, that's nice.
Okay. Huh? And especially around your neck and your brain area.
My brain?
Yeah.
Why, I need it?
Yeah. Well, I mean, we realize it's small, but you still need it. But there's some scar tissues on your brain that they want to.
Probably from being slammed so much.
Yeah.
It happened. I mean,
well, my doctor told me when I had my ear operation, I'll never forget it, no matter how small it is, it could be a pea brain, we still have brain. I said, thank you.
As long as it works.
And also, there's something about you need some healing on your chest.
Really?
I want to encourage you to drink a lot more water. And I would also encourage you to drink a lot of lemon with tea.
Okay, I think you had mentioned that last time.
Yeah.
And
I also will tell you that there's something. Does your wife have sinus problems?
No, she has a few other things going on, but,
don't be afraid to do, you know what Reiki energy is, right?
Yes.
Okay. Don't be afraid to do some Reiki energy. She may not try to rebuke it, but when she sees it, when she starts feeling the tension on there, then she's going to allow you to.
Okay.
Do you want to move out of this state altogether?
No.
Besides getting married in Vegas, what else is in Vegas?
I don't want to move. I just want to visit places. I don't mind staying here and just travel, like with our thing that we're doing.
I'm telling you now, when you believe, you can rebuff me all you want, and I love it when people do that, don't you?
No, I'm saying,
but I'm telling you, you got to have your own school. Wow. You're not going to be actually, you know, the wrestling part. You're going to be like more on the watching of the people, because you can't get into the ring. You already know, even if you try.
Well, I can still get in. I'm not crippled. I can still get in
but
there.
You're going to mess up your back.
Was it already messed up?
You might become crippled. I think is what Norm's trying to tell you.
But I tell you, you are going to open up a school, and I'm telling you now that you're going to be showing other people, no, we're going to do it this way. No, we're going to, and you're going to have the subject about another former WWE wrestler who's going to be working with you.
But you realize we're going to be so busy with our show, I won't have time. Because our show is going
to... I love it. Good.
When people see our show on TV, they're going to stick to it like a magnet. They're not going to be able to get away because it's going to be the greatest show on TV today.
But I'm telling you, you're going to have it.
See, I think it's because of Adventurecam that you're going to do this camp. And it's just a camp. It's not like year-round. And somebody's going to approach you. They're going to want to, throw your name up there.
And you're
going to be the
administrator.
Influence.
Yeah.
So you don't have to be there all the time. You're still going to be able to do Adventure Cam.
Yeah.
That's the way I see that.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to thank you. You just put it with it. Because it's going to be like another satellite. Like what I do here, I've had a lot of people come off of my show. And this is what's going to be happening with his show. You're still going to have that, okay? So relax.
I understand what you're saying. When we take a break from the show, I could do that on the side.
Right.
Correct.
Right, okay. And it's not that far to the future. It really isn't. And your wife has got, hi, hon. Oh, you're on your way again. When are you ever going to effing stay home here,
Sorry, honey, but we need the money.
Do you have a passport?
Yes.
Do you?
Have a passport.
Passport.
Yes, I do.
Okay. Because there's something up in Canada.
Oh.
Yeah, some brook. What do you call it? Brooks or rivers or canals, the little streamy things there, And there's a couple of log cabins, like a lodges or something like that, you're going to be going into.
Don't everybody have to have a passport now? Did that pass the law?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you should have.
I've had one for a long time.
When I go to Canada, I always have one.
Yeah.
I just got my third magazine for my photography up in Canada. And I did a movie poster for them. Story on the horses. This is all horse related, all equine magazines and stuff that I'm doing some work with a charity for endangered horses, the Newfoundland ponies. And I'm working with a farm out here in New Hampshire that I do all the photography for free and, try to get the name out and the word out and some good pictures of them.
Actually, last year we did that, didn't we? We had a lot of the people come in from the horses here, that horse. Helping here or whatever they were, they had the horses that came. This lady came in and she raised. Were you with me? Yeah.
No idea what you're talking about.
Upreach.
Oh yeah. Okay. Different, around Goffstown area.
Yeah, and then they have another one who fed the horses, who raised money, helped feed the horses, and then we had the one, Live and Let Live.
They haven't been on since I've been on.
Then we'll have to get them back on. Okay, because winter's coming up, and but I believe. Like with my show and yours as well, what you're doing, we need to give back to the community what we receive. That's what I love doing my event. Every year I say, I've had it, I'm not going to do it anymore, But if I can do it two more years, I'll be happy, And last year was phenomenal. My goal is to make between 12 and 1,500. We raised almost 1,100, a little over.
Almost 12.
Yeah, so my goal is to, and when I had them at the hotels, I didn't make anything for maybe $200 or $300. Yeah. And it's funny when I did it for the food bank, I made $200 or $300 for them. But when I do it for the animals, it's amazing how much more you get out of it.
Wow.
Let's be honest, there is a lot of things out there, a lot of charities that give to the food to the homeless and stuff like that. Animals will always be my first love as far as giving charity go back.
Yeah.
Because they truly give you unconditional love.
Yeah, it's really amazing. Do. When I'm in with the ponies, I go with my camera, I walk in the middle of them, and they'll just come up to me, they hit me in the back, they just want to, a little quick pat, and that's all they wanted. It's amazing. And I've been lucky enough to be recognized, for those pictures and, helping the ponies.
So you're grateful for what you have.
Yeah.
And you don't take it for granted.
And you know what's good? The Holton Mansion asked him, they want to make a calendar. They want him to do the pictures.
Oh, nice.
That's what we're doing this weekend.
So I'll do that all for free just to help them out and, kind of give back to what they've given us. And And I think that's, you know, a big deal. You know,
yeah, absolutely. When you get it done, let me know. We'll promote it here.
Oh, that'd be great.
Okay.
Yeah,
great.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, absolutely. You know, one hand washes the other.
Oh, very good.
You know?
Scratch my back, I'll scratch yours.
Well, I don't like to be touched. No, but it's true. Thank you, Stretcher, yeah. But I, but the whole thing, you gotta work. I don't care what people do. You gotta work together.
Correct.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
All this hate, all this violence, all this garbage. Well, this Republican said that you ate too many chocolates, so we can't vote for you. Or this one, well, you stole my chocolate. Or you went out with my wife, so I can't. But it seems like the worse the scandal is, the more the politicians are going to get elected.
Yeah.
And that's just a sad commentary on us, that we are that gullible,
yeah,
sheep.
And you know what, folks? If you don't vote, don't complain.
Right.
Exactly.
Because your vote does matter. Yeah. No matter what you think, your vote matters.
And I'm kind of hearing the black lives matter and the white, blue one. Every life matters.
I'm with you on that, too. It's
every life. I get called a racist because I say every life matters. But every single one of us matter.
And
if you don't think so, I'll poke you in the eye.
And the thing about the voters, too, it's get informed. You know, go out and do your research and don't go by what everybody else is saying.
If they say it on TV, don't believe it.
Exactly. I mean, I do my own thing, you know, and I find out the facts and I do my research, and that's how I.
Well, that's like what I say to you about, you know, the Dunkin' Donuts. Do your research. See how you feel about it, you know.
Yeah.
I'm not that, because, you know, don't jump and say to do it because I said to. I just want to, you know, I just throw it up because my spirit tells me to.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I tell people, you don't have to believe me. I don't care. I'll take your money. I'm not, you know, I don't care. But and then I get calls back. And tell me, like, I had a lady, I went and did a show, I think it was in Derry, at the Garish Building, I think it was, or no, one in Londonderry.
The Healing Tree?
Yeah. And she said, can I come in and talk to you? I go, yeah. I didn't remember when I was. But she said, I didn't believe a damn word you said. I said, that's okay. I said, you were pretty angry, huh? She goes, yeah, I was. But then she said, everything you said happened. She said, did you curse? I go, I don't have time for curses. You know? And so. And then another lady used to call me every name in the book. Then she called me to let me know that her daughter had a baby girl. And that four doctors had told her she could never have children.
Wow.
And I said, you got a baby girl coming. What do you know? You know, I love it. You know, when I see something and I get confirmation, we have gotten calls from California here, Florida, Tennessee,
England.
Georgia, England, yeah, you know, so.
Missouri.
This is what's
going to
happen with you guys. This is why I ask you if you have passports,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Yeah.
Are you able to be ready to go to England to do, can you afford to go? Now, always know this, whenever the spirits want you to go somewhere, like we'll say go to Scotland, go to Nova Scotia. Remember I told you I see you go to Newfoundland and Nova Scotia?
Yes.
And I still see it. Always do. Know this, what it's meant for you to go there, the money's going to be there. Always, 9 out of 10, they will pay for you to go there.
Oh.
When I go to like New York or wherever, I go and I'm very blessed to have a town car, a limousine drive me to the airport, and then from there I fly, and then they have a hotel for me, and you know, stuff like that. And because whatever we do, we earn the right to, whether it's bad, good, or indifferent. Always know, whatever you do, like when you had all that wonderful thing. I actually went back and watched some of your wrestling the other day.
Did you?
Yeah, it was cool.
Thank you.
I cried for you one time when you got really hit. It looked like your head was really bleeding badly. And I'm like, oh my God, you know.
But it's actually real blood.
Yeah. Yeah, you cut yourself in a razor
blade. Yeah, they tape it.
I see. That's why I would love to have been a manager. Is Bobby Heenan still alive?
Yeah, but he has cancer.
Yeah,
he's really.
Oh, we have a call.
Oh, all right.
Welcome to Norm and Friends. You're on the air.
Hi, Laurie. How you doing?
Good. How are you, Mary?
Not too bad. Not too bad. They just come back from the MRI and everything.
Yeah. What'd they say, Mary?
They won't say anything. They'll wait for the doctor.
Yeah. And now when you're gonna go get your artery checked out, your veins?
I go the 24th. No, I go the 24th and see that doctor.
Okay.
He'll let me know what's gonna go on with that.
Okay. Well, what you need to do is find some hot looking young man and have him take you around.
Hey, there we go.
This is the one that makes the best homemade baked beans. Remember the beans we had at the event?
Oh, yeah.
This is the one. But, Mary, I actually see a lot of healing coming for you this year.
Oh, I hope so, John.
John. Wow.
Just don't call me too late for dinner. Yeah. I really do. She's been so sick.
John, hang up.
Yeah. She's been so sick that she hadn't been able to come to play Scrabble.
Right,
with
right.
Yeah,
right. Is your car better, Mary?
Yes, it is. That got fixed, and it's running much better.
Nice.
Okay, so maybe this week we can give you a call. You can come over for dinner.
All righty, Norm.
Okay. And we have here Adventurecam.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, Mary.
Hello, how you doing?
Good. Very good. I wish you the best of luck.
Yes.
Thank you.
You remember them being at the event, right?
Huh?
You remember them being at the last second event, plus being on the show, right?
Yeah.
Jerry's the one that wore that Indian pygmy, what do they call them? The Indian thong man that they
Serape,
wore.
Serape?
Yes.
You wore a thong.
Yeah.
You wore a thong.
Yeah, that's
Keith.
Yeah.
Oh, I must have missed that.
Me too. All right, Tom, I'll let you go, and we'll catch you guys later.
Hey, Mary, keep me posted on how well you're doing. If you're not doing anything, I'm going to give you a call Sunday and probably have you get together for dinner, all right?
All righty, Norm. Okay. We'll catch you.
All right,
Mary. Bye.
Yeah,
bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Yeah, Lily.
Hey, do you want to show the other DVD?
Huh?
Yes, show the other DVD.
Yeah.
Sure, no problem.
On the Victorian mansion.
I love when God hears us.
It's a quick clip. It's not like the other one.
How about roll the ball or put the flashlight on? It's your choice. Whoa!
Holy crap!
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wow.
That was so nice of you.
Thank you for doing that.
Is this a male? Could you shut that off so we can ask you another question?
It's just paused again. He's messing with this. I'm gonna put this recorder right beside the flashlight. Can you please talk into the recorder? Thank you.
How about roll the ball or put the flashlight on? It's your choice. Whoa!
Holy
Thank
crap!
You. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wow.
That was so nice of you.
Thank you for doing that.
Is this a male? Could you shut that off so we can ask you another question?
It's just paused again. He's messing with this. I'm gonna put this recorder right beside the flashlight. Can you please talk into the recorder? Thank you.
I would love to have you come on more, again, probably like in July.
Sure.
Because I booked right up now until June. Mm-hmm. Because we love this stuff. See, the one thing I like about it, you're not afraid or bashful about showing us what you're doing with your adventures. I've invited a couple of other people to come on the show, but they somehow... Oh, yeah, we'll come on, but we never see them. And that's okay, you know. But I think it's pretty awesome. If you're willing to come back on, we're willing to show more.
Oh, we'd love to. Agree? We always have a good time.
I'll tell you what I'll do. I will do this for you. I will give you a whole half hour. I'm being generous, aren't I?
Oh, you don't have to. Just give us 30 minutes. That's good.
No, okay. I'm putting you a show. Seriously. The next time you come on, I will commit... I'm going to be on the spotlight for 30 minutes.
I know. It's
I'm at 29 minutes, all right?
Yeah, okay. 29 and a half minutes.
Yeah,
okay.
There you go.
No, but honestly, I would like to have you come in with a show for a half hour.
Yeah,
I have never, ever done this with anybody before.
Wow, that'd be awesome.
And I'm really serious on that. As far as you know, I never have, right?
No. Heck, you don't even have my website up there. You put Kevin's up there, I just want to say.
Nothing. Yeah, I didn't know that. I didn't know they were going
to
do that.
So that means we get to sit over there? You guys get to sit here?
Sure. Absolutely.
You could be our guest.
Yeah.
You have to answer the phone, though.
Yeah.
It's all right.
Mm. Okay. Uh-oh. And you have to do the readings.
I'll leave that to him.
But I really will. My thing is, because that's how much I want to see you people. Sit. And I've never done this, believe me, before.
You appreciate it very much.
Very grateful for that.
I'm attracted to his beard.
My beard.
So he'll come in the next. He'll come in next week with all. No, actually, because I really believe in what. And if you get pictures of the horses that you take, don't be afraid to bring some of those in. We're going to make it your show.
Oh, that'd be amazing. I'd love to, talk about the Newfoundland ponies a little bit too. Then,
you can talk some now. Talk away. Talk about what you do.
Less than 400.
Just waiting for Al to call.
We got less than 400 in the world. You know, Newfoundland ponies, they're outstanding breed. They very tough animal, very friendly animal. They're like puppies more than they are, what you'd think of as a horse. When I go in, like I said, when I go in with them, it's just, they're so positive. The energy is incredible, and it's just a beautiful experience. And so there's like 10 of them that they're gonna be moving. And I'm not sure exactly the location now, but out past Peterborough area, and
And that's what I just read in the paper about.
It may be.
There was a write-up in one of the papers about that.
Yeah, it's these things are incredible. It's just amazing, and the people that care for them, George and Emily, unbelievable people, and just they're so positive. They believe in the good energy, and we work so well together. And just I'll just go up there and do whatever I can, bring people up there with us, and. And hopefully, some people can give a little bit and help support, just a bag of feed or a bale of hay. This means a lot. And these people that work from sun up to sundown, right. and then some. And it's all for the love of the animals. And if that's what gets me.
Actually, if they want to come on with you too, I would be more than honored to have them come on.
Oh, that'd be amazing. I'd love to have them come on.
There we get, we our show is we give back to the community.
It's amazing.
You can even bring them on. Separate from Adventurecam.
Okay.
If you want to, just
let me know, my address, let me know, and all that,
Oh, definitely.
And we can make a whole 2-hour show with them as well.
Oh, they would love that too.
Because I'm a firm believer, whatever we receive, we have to give back.
Yeah, that makes me feel good. I appreciate that.
You can't bring the horse in. I'm terrified.
Oh, here
of
we go.
Really? Yeah. Come on.
That's a different story now. Come on.
It's a horse of a different color right there.
Right. Yeah. Horses and I have an understanding. I'll like you, but I won't go near you. They're not very big, are they? Or are they?
They're very tall. They're not like little ponies when you think of a pony. And it's just, they're up to like 14 hands, I believe, which is a good size. They're rideable by adults, some of the bigger ones.
Well, if you think of it, you get home, have them contact me so we can set up an arrangement with you for them to come on.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
I think that would be exciting.
Absolutely. I think that'd be very exciting.
You think we do it for the Manchester Animal Shelter? Maybe we can do a fundraiser or a psychic event for them.
Oh, man. I would love that.
I tell all these other charities, I'll be very happy to do a psychic event for you. Oh, yeah. This is, they don't fall through, and that's okay.
No, some of them just aren't there yet.
But if we will do, at least I will commit, and I will not take any money for the event. And we'll all go to them.
That's
like what I do in the Manchester Animal Shelter. I don't take money from it. It all goes. Actually, I pay to have it done, but that's okay because this is something that I want to do.
That's amazing. And, to me, I said, this is very near and dear to my heart,
That startled me.
Call coming in.
Hello, Al.
Hey, Norm. How's your show going? Good?
Hey, we're doing very good. We have a show called
Adventure Cam
with Rick and Jerry. There you go.
How'd you like the weather today, Norm? 70s.
I didn't like it.
I loved it, Al. Today's perfect.
Okay, well, doesn't he want me to call that?
For the weekend.
He's amped his cell phone when he tries to call it.
We're in the 70s today, so how's you got a lot of calls today?
Not even one.
You got one.
Yeah.
Mary.
Yeah. No, we've been so busy talking about what they've been doing, it's been good.
Anyway, Norm and Laurie, everyone, tonight we'll have a mostly clear evening, increasing clouds after midnight. Temperatures are holding the 50s tonight, a warm night. Rain develops by midday afternoon tomorrow, highs tomorrow, upper 50s to low 60s.
50s, a little cooler than today. Some heavy rain tomorrow night, 40s. The rain ends the clearing on Friday, 50 or 55 degrees. And the weekend looks dry. We'll be in the upper 50s, possibly low 60s Saturday with lots of sun, and then increasing clouds on Sunday, 50s. So it looks like we will see, we could see an inch or more rain, possibly, as the low pressure moves along the frontal system tomorrow night. So we are going to get some more heavy rain, but then the weekend looks mild, too. Not as warm as today, though.
Well, that's a good thing.
Carolina, and then we play at home tomorrow night, Carolina and Hurricanes, and the New York Islanders on Saturday at home.
Oh, yeah, I think we're going to win both of those games.
You're optimistic.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Well, look at that. Look at the last overtime on the Bruins here. One of the 30 seconds, they got gold.
Yeah.
You know.
And what do you think? I like that coach, Claude Schumann. He said when they practice on the ice, he's out there with skates. I think he's a great coach. I think he's helped
him
a lot.
Oh, yeah. He's very encouraging to him, you know. And see, the Bruins are still going through a lot of transitions. And you got a lot of the referees that do not like any of the New England teams, you know. So the Bruins are going to they're going to win the Super Bowl. I mean, the Stanley Cup.
Some of those players have been very good.
Yeah, they have. I miss the old days when they had fistfights, though.
No.
You know, like that.
We'll talk to you soon. Have a good night.
And you too. Bye-bye, Al.
Bye, Al.
Bye now.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.
He never accepted my friend request. He's not on Facebook?
Yeah. He did?
No, he never did.
Oh. Well, I'll give him a hand next time I talk to him.
Yeah. He probably didn't even
I always say that.
That's why I didn't know if he was ever on.
I always make sure, like the night before or whatever, that I watched like the last 2 or 3 minutes of the hockey game. I don't know a damn thing about hockey.
Neither do I.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't
but
watch
you know
sports.
What? He does. And we're really good friends.
That's nice.
Know?
Yeah.
Oh, I went to a restaurant called Rena Mays. And I cannot consciously recommend the people in there.
Really?
That bad, huh? Where's that located?
It's over past CMC, not going toward Bedford.
Sure not to go that way.
And, I mean, they get great reviews. Folks, this is only my opinion, not anybody else's, but mine, okay? And I just can't, you know. I felt sorry for the waitress. The only thing I got a little annoyed when she said, I sat down, I said, why did you go to the kitchen instead of waiting on the, well, I had to wait on the lady in the kitchen first. I said, but she works here. Shouldn't you wait on your customers first? Because she said she was waiting on somebody else. I said, oh my God, there must be spirit she's waiting on. She didn't have a sense of humor.
No.
Don't you hate that?
Yeah.
I don't like when you go to a restaurant and they're rude. It's like, I won't go back.
No.
Or I'll ask for somebody else.
Yeah. And then when we went to another place and they want me to come back up by, UP called the DW Diner up on South Main Street. And I was not impressed with them. The food was okay, but as far as the waitress service goes, until towards the end, another waitress came over. We first went in there. If I was going to rate them from 1 being the highest, 10 being the lowest, they would have got a 12.
Wow.
But that's not a DW Diner anymore.
No, it's some other name.
We like the DW Diner in Merrimack.
Yeah, now, see,
like
that was when the DW Diner first opened up here, it was fantastic. I don't know what happened, but then, I guess I kind of spoiled about Belmont Hall. Typical there?
I've been here many times.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, yeah, you know,
find a parking spot.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
It's horrible.
Yeah. They get a buffet for Easter breakfast.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And I treat like a celebrity when I go. Oh. You know, oh, yeah. Yeah. So, and Anna just got back from Argentina.
Yeah, I talked to her quite a bit on Facebook.
Yeah, she's an awesome lady.
There's one waitress there I don't like because she never smiles, and I don't like a waitress that don't smile.
Oh,
she
I don't
no
either.
Personality. It's like, take a walk, eat somebody else.
You know what? I went to Dairy Queen the other day, and I could not. Well, I had an awesome cheeseburger with bacon. I'm not supposed to eat it, but I love their cheeseburger.
Shame on you, Norman. No better.
But it was just so good, and I was so excited. I met a lady there that has lost 180 pounds.
Really?
She get rid of a husband?
Probably. But she looked so, I had told her she was going to lose weight 3 or 4 years. And she goes, yeah, right, yeah. And I was just so excited to see how healthy she looks. She believes in God and all that. And I said, that's awesome. And just the positive energy that she had. Because the time when they first opened up, I got upset. I'm watching this cooking. He was you know, and I'm like, whoa, yeah. I'm not going. I'm a germ freak to begin with, yeah. You know, and plus, what I like is the waitress at Rita Bay's, everything on small plate. I go, yeah. And when they had the pan fries, instead of having a little bit of grease, it felt like they just put them on top of the stove and let them burn and like chocolate. Oh. And once again, I'm sure other people had better results. And I had asked for sausage, and she said, I didn't hear you. I go, okay. You know?
Yeah.
But, you know, folks, I'm not condemning the place. There are a lot of people there. She's been there quite a while, so they must be doing something right. But once again, that's only my opinion.
I like Mojo's.
The one over on...
SD6.
I've never been there.
You know what I'm talking about?
Uh-uh.
You go off SD6, off 93. I think it's Hanover Street.
Oh, that one? Oh, Moe's?
Moe's.
Yeah.
It's called Mojo's.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you.
Exactly.
Thank you, God.
Thank you. They're really good. They give you good portions. I get 2 meals out of it.
Yeah.
Okay. I never go over that way, so.
I've been, they do have great food. But yeah. We did a radio show there, and I was very disappointed. They didn't. They said we wouldn't have to pay and all that stuff, because we promoted them, and we still end up paying.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Well, I like the Golden.
I'm starting to get hungry now.
Yeah. I like the Golden Rod.
Yeah, I haven't been there in a long time. My folks go there a lot.
Yeah. And actually, I met one of my friends, Dick Del Cava. Do you know Dick?
Yes, I know Dick.
And actually, I got him into doing the readings and stuff like that. And I walked over to him, and I said, it was a real cold day, and I forgot to ask for sugar and cream in the coffee, so I got it black, and I was too embarrassed to go back and ask. And I'm looking at his wife, Debbie, lovely, lovely people.
Yeah,
Debbie,
I finally met her, yeah, did really you? Nice yeah. lady.
And I said, Debbie, I want you to know that your mother's okay. She is wrapped in gold and purple shroud all around her. And she looks at me, you know, you're a weirdo and all this, you know, which I would too if you didn't know me. And I only consider myself a weirdo anyway, you know. And then I started talking with him. I told him about his truck that needed advertising. And then we became beautiful friends. We became really very good friends. And I was honored and had the pleasure of going to his son's graduation party, you know, and stuff like that. Then I pick on him like I pick on everybody else, you know.
Yeah.
And but he's a tremendous gentleman. We've got our own paths. And believe me, I've seen a lot of people on the spiritual path. We all go on different paths, you know. Just like you're going to be going on your path, you know. I will tell you, even though it sucks that we have to be like 60 and 70 years old or 60 years old, also we start seeing all this success, you know. And but it's a time, but that's the way the time is. We have to go the journey to be where we are, okay? I'm going to have to put your website up after, from Bellworth, okay? And you said you don't have a, you know, do you have a website?
No, not really.
Okay. Just, but if they want to get a hold of you to find out more information on what you do, how would they do that?
Facebook is probably the easiest and most familiar to most people, in that, you know, Adventure Cam's on there, Rich Damboise, either one. They're going to find all the information they need to find out more about the show. Go to Adventure Cam, and every link is there, right to the YouTube channel. It's got everything, little updates here and there, and bloopers every once in a while of the show.
Bloopers are nice.
Especially this guy.
Website?
I do.
Yeah. Okay.
AutoHeart.com.
Okay. God, can you find a way to put AutoHearts.com on the show next week and have it permanently? Yeah, thank you. And I'm going to be doing 2 private parties this weekend.
Good for
One's
you.
One's in Derry, and one I'm going back to New Boston. I go there every year.
Yeah.
I love going back there to New Boston. The first time I went there, I thought I was in hillbilly town. They literally had these cars up outside the road going up over the hill in the mountain. I expected to see a homebrew distillery, a White Lightning and stuff, let me tell you. And what a bunch of wonderful people they really were. And they had these sliding doors. I wasn't stoned either. I walked right into the doors twice.
Oh,
the second time, I had smoked a whole day cigarette, and then I walked right into it again. I'm like, whoa.
Wow.
What a bunch of wonderful people, though. I've been very blessed at the parties that I do and where I go. You know, if you give love, you're going to get love back.
Yep.
You know.
Absolutely.
And if you go in there with a negative attitude, you get a negative attitude.
Yeah.
You know. I've had clients that I've actually would say, I prefer you not to come. I had one couple, they were kind of overweight. They had been drinking. And I won't refuse to do people that are drunk, because it's not, I'm getting down at night. And my dog, I have a little short-haired chariot chihuahua, right? She's the ball. And here these, try to picture these people running down a porch, you know, and my little dog ain't chasing them down the hallway. Oh, yeah. Their energy was so, you're going to read me. I go, no, I'm not. Yeah, you are. You are. No, I'm not. Because I'm not going to be responsible. I said, but I will do this for you. You get into that car, and I guarantee 5 minutes later, you're going to get nailed for DWI.
Yeah.
I always wondered if it happened that way.
Yeah, well,
and will I ever tell, and Lori's the same way, we both say the same thing, that are we 100% accurate? No. You'll see a lot of people like that. I think they got California psychics on there, and they'll tell you they're 100%. You can't do that.
No one is 100% accurate.
Only me, because I'm God, but no, you know. But if we start with
God, you said that, because he might not talk to us anymore.
That's true, too. Yeah, that's true. You know, we used to have this young man, he had a voice, and the name was Brett. We used to call him God One. And we used to pick that, and I used to pick on him. But then he fell in love. He was, yeah, you were here.
Brett.
Yeah. And he fell in love. We used to pick on him, all of that, you know. Now, one thing that I do with my show is I never refuse to have, you can either dislike us and tell us, come on. If you're going to dislike us, come on in here and tell us. Don't go hide behind, because if you're going to email me, I'm going to read it.
Yeah.
You know, and I've done it many a times, you know. Or if you've got a positive, great, I'll read that. But if you're going to say, well, you know, stuff. Like you. See, that's one thing about you is if they don't like it, okay, tell me why.
Yeah, that's it.
Because you know not everybody is going to like what you're doing. I have to be very honest with you. I really did not like that at first. With you guys. Ghost, I said to myself, oh my God, I think I might have even said that to you. Oh my God, another Ghost Hunters type thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because you see so many of them. Mm-hmm. But now I have to tell you what you're doing, and what even greatly impressed me was that take that you had.
Wow. Thank you.
And I think we might, if you don't mind, we might even close out with that.
That works for me.
Okay. John, do we have time left to play that one more time, that 5 minute one?
God must have stepped away.
Oh, okay. Well, okay. But we are planning on having you come back on. But like I said, get a hold of me.
Sure.
And you can come on with them and tell them what you
awesome.
Do. Okay. You can bring the pictures in or whatever. Make a whole new show. Okay.
That'd be great.
And the next time you guys come on yourself, we'll give you a whole half hour.
Wow.
But you're not going to know when.
Okay.
So we can't prepare it.
Be surprised.
That spirit will. Right.
Yeah.
That sound like a good deal?
Sounds that sounds
okay, you know.
And again, we really appreciate the time that you guys have given us already. It's been amazing.
You know what? You know, one hand helps the other. You know, like you're coming to the event, which we appreciate, okay?
Right.
And that brings in a lot of people. There was that one lady got all upset with me when I shaved curly hair, wore glasses. I was picking on you and saying to her, you really know him? Oh, she got all upset with me. I don't
Who
remember her
that?
Name. She wore gold rimmed glasses, curly hair. Kind of an older lady.
Oh, really?
Well, you see so many people. You know,
yeah, I don't remember who's who.
Yeah, you know.
So where are you doing your autograph signing?
It's in Boston. It's at, I think it's a Matthews Arena. I'm not sure. It's some arena out there. There's going to be a lot of wrestlers there.
Excellent.
That must be exciting.
Yeah, it is.
Do you get free tickets when they come here to Manchester?
No.
They,
they used to do that, but Vince don't do it no more.
No, he's too much about money.
He doesn't want anybody in there unless you're on the card. So,
well,
before you could go in there and just hang out with the guys, no more.
Well, he charges for autographs.
Charges for everything.
Yeah. Well, you know what? That's what made him who he is today.
I know, but still.
He's forgetting that. Because he could care less about you. You know that.
Of course.
Yeah. John Cena made it very clear. You're here today and gone tomorrow, like when Ben won. Oh, look at Hulk Hogan. What, 30 years ago he made a comment, and now they just...
Bringing it back.
Bring it back. And
he's
they
in court the other day.
Yeah. And they took everything away from him.
Yeah.
He lost his Hall of Fame. He lost everything. Does he really care? No. You know? But it's sad. Something that happened 30 years ago, like Paul and Dean, was that her name?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That these comments that are made 20, 30 years ago, 40 years ago, why are they doing it, you know?
And it's like whoever has not made an off comment, throw the first stone kind of thing, you know what I mean? It's just everybody, you know, says something in their life that can always come back and bite them.
Yeah. Well, look at Peyton Manning now. They're all after him for all the stuff he might have done while he was in college, what, 20 years ago?
Oh,
now they're bringing in sexual assault. Oh, they're bringing that against him.
Yeah, you know, I'm sorry. I don't know this woman, obviously. This is totally bogus. Why you are trying to destroy this man at the end of his career, you've had more than enough time to bring these up and talk about it. If it was legit, I think she would have.
Yeah.
I just think this is just trying to destroy his career at the end, and I just think that is sad and pathetic.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Have you got anything that we might expose here at our show?
I think you know everything. You know what's going on with
hell.
Who?
I want something bad. I want to expose it like the...
Maybe in the future.
Yeah. I want to know. You know what it is? We're welcome to Norman Fred. We expose all. Have you got any hidden secrets that we can expose?
Not anymore. No. I'm working on it, though.
Oh, okay.
He's trying to make some. So.
Yeah.
Okay. See, the one thing I know is I'm an open book. I could kill one.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. And because I know... that where my journey has brought me to where I've been and all that, I'm not embarrassed for it. Everything happens in life, and everything happens for a reason.
Correct.
Okay. Well, folks, we have had, it's been a delight having you two on.
Thanks, guys.
And thank you
thank
for coming
you very
on.
Much.
Don't tell me their names. John and Jim, right? No, I'll get it.
Try
I don't
again.
Know.
Come on, you got it.
Jerry.
Jerry with a J.
Yeah, and
I'm not poor, but I am.
Exactly. Oh, okay, rich. Isn't that awful? Sorry about that, folks.
The worst part is you had it written.
I know. I could have gone here and looked, right? But I want to thank you two for coming on. And remember, every day you guys are the winners.
Pleasure's all ours. We
love
it.
This is a blast.
Everybody out here, I hope you enjoyed having them on as much as we did. I don't care, but, you know, we do care, folks.
Thank
and remember
we'll
this. Every day you guys are the winners. And you're the stars.